great towards us, and the truth of the Lord endures forever. Praise ye the Lord. I bless y'all. Psalms 117. May the Lord have a blessing of you and hear and do in this world.
Amen.
God be over.
Yeah,
yeah.
amen.
Amen.
Church, say amen again.
Amen.
All right, on behalf of our beloved Pastor Green, the Sons of the House, and the Mount Nebo family, I want to say welcome to the final night of revival.
All right.
Friday night.
All right.
And we're glad to see you.
All right.
It reminds me of a funny story I was telling a little bit earlier.
Mm-hmm.
Years ago, before I got saved, I used to go to church two times a year, Easter and Christmas.
All right.
So I went to an Easter Mass over the Catholic service on base,
mm-hmm.
and the priest said, you know what, I've never seen this many people show up since I've been here.
Yeah.
And then he said, come back, we do this every Sunday.
All right.
So again, my invitation is, come back, we do this every Sunday.
All right.
So welcome again, and we love you.
I'll tell you what, we're going to do our offering.
All right.
And then after that, the choir is going to come. And after that, Pastor Pamela Thomas is going to come and break the bread of life. Amen.
For some 30, some 60, some 104. In your son Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. I thank you for the privilege once again to be able to share on this blessed occasion.
Amen.
As I stand in your presence, I pray that you would lead me the way that I should go. Pray now, Lord, that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart will be acceptable in thy sight.
Right.
O Lord, my strength and my redeemer, in the name of Jesus, I pray.
Right.
Amen and thank you.
Right.
God bless you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Choir, for numbers. So appreciate the support from the Eastside family. Mm-hmm. Say to Pastor Blaine, my beloved brother, members of the clergy, sons of this house and officers and members. It's just good to be here.
All right.
Yes. We're about to close out last night of revival and pray that something that's been said to inspire you and get your mind rethinking on different things.
All right.
Amen. I've got a list of one of my associate ministers calling, and he's on his way to Houston at this time, and he just called and wanted to wish me Godspeed. So we thank God for his support, even though he's on the road.
All right.
Amen. To all of you that are here, the Eastside family, where you are, just wave your hand, Eastside, and the family. All right. It's good to see you. Amen. We thank God for your support.
All right.
Now, tonight we close out with a very familiar passage that you've heard a number of times. It's going to come from 14th chapter of Gospel of St. John. John chapter 14. Amen. All right, we're going to then look at those first three verses in that chapter. John chapter 14, verses 1 through 3. Yeah, thanks for this. Of course, we'll have some supporting scriptures that will then be suitable for this particular night. Amen. From the book of John, chapter 14, beginning with verse 1. If you dare say amen.
Amen.
That's good. And it reads thusly, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will do what?
Come
again and do what? And receive you unto me. That what? For I am that in me also. And again, scripture supports our theme for this week. Amen. Will you be ready when Jesus comes? Will you be ready when Jesus comes? How many of y'all have been praying for him this week?
Oh, yeah.
Amen. I need your prayer. Come on up. I appreciate it. Amen. Need your prayer tonight.
Will you converse with Diane?
Okay. You want to break that up? Thank God for you.
Getting together on some music or something. I'm grateful for all of you.
But man, I appreciate the support,
right,
that I received from this church.
Yes,
pastor, a friend of mine, and it will always be that way. I don't see no end to that.
All right.
Amen. We had a wonderful day today. Had a chance to share with one of my friends. A lot of things I got involved with, but most of the day I've been kind of unwinding yesterday.
Right.
Thank God for a good day.
Mm-hmm.
And did the lawn service early this morning.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe woke up a few people, but couldn't wait till 12 o'clock to cut.
All right.
But now they got too old and it's too hot. Amen. We're grateful for a good day. Careful, this heat is, I'm telling you, it's not playing.
Right.
You have to really watch yourself in it. Most of all, if you stay hydrated, you can do pretty good. what the Lord has to say to us tonight. And in our lesson, this lesson is penned to us by none other than that of the Apostle John. Amen. John was a member of the inner circle. Amen. They were members of that circle was Peter, James, and John. Amen. They were very close to Jesus. Amen. And we find that John is the one that when Jesus was on the cross, and he told his mother, he looked at it and said, "Hold thy son." And vice versa. He told him that that was his mother. So what he was doing, he was making provisions for his mother when he leaves. And we must understand without hesitation, without reservation, that Jesus, even though he was God, but he was 100% human as well. Yet he did not sin. Now, see what he means? He had an earthly mother by the name of Mary. And now, just notice that John, you know, he didn't put his mother in anybody's hands. Put his mother in the hands of one that he felt like he could trust. John was considered as one of the beloved apostles. Amen. We find that in looking, and when they were in the upper room, we discovered that John was so close to Jesus that he just kind of laid his head upon his breast in the last night. That they were, amen, that he was, when he was crucified. Amen. That's showing the sign that he did love his Savior. Wouldn't it be a good thing if everybody just loved the Lord and showed evidence that you truly love the Lord. Amen. If you love the Lord, then you'll be busy about the business of the Lord. Amen. I believe that if you had the love of God in you, that you wouldn't have to be coerced into doing those things that you ought to do. It ought to be an automatic thing. Because I love the Lord, then I'm going to do what the Lord tells me. Amen. Just an example, if you have a spouse, amen, if you never, amen, showed any sign, never said, you love them at any time, then they're going to be wondering if you really, really care about amen. You ain't going to, you know, tell a spouse that you love them and you never support them in any kind of way. I know that I love Jesus. And that's why I'm busy about trying to satisfy him while I'm on this side. Does anybody out there love the Lord? One of the things I can say in the word of a song is that, oh, how I love Jesus. And the reason they said I love him because what he was first loved me. And he is Savior of the world, and he loves all mankind. Whether sinner or not, he still loves everybody. Amen. We pointed out the other night, amen, that it's his will that everybody would be saved. He wished that nobody would go to hell. And I pointed out the fact that there are some who will go. But we must keep in mind that they go not because he sent them, but because they sent themselves. That's an individual decision. Amen. He does that. And the thing about hell is just a fact of man reading our Bible is that it actually wasn't designed for mankind. It wasn't put there for us. It was designed for the devil. And his angels. That's the book. It wasn't designed for us. But unfortunately, you have to confess with your mouth and believe in your heart.
Yes,
and then you will shall be saved. That's not a lot of it.
Yeah.
He didn't put a whole lot of record thing on salvation.
Uh-huh.
As some people, amen, they think that you have to do a whole lot of things in order to be saved.
Yeah.
And but all it takes is belief in the Lord Jesus Christ,
right,
the Son of God. Believe in him and trust him and do his will.
Yeah.
What you shall be saved.
Right.
Amen. I don't believe in the stuff they talk about. You have to be able to speak in tongues in order to be saved.
Cindy. Down from here.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good one. I don't need no wings to get there. I don't need no chariot to get there. But he's going to bring it to me.
Yeah.
Oh, somebody let him down. Just like he brought the salvation. He's going to bring me that new. New city. That's a good new song. Yeah, so this preacher been preaching all week long. Good, you be ready. Made it personal. It's time for everybody to check themselves. And say, Lord, I want to be ready. Amen. God bless you. And God keep you. Any announcements? Amen. God bless you.
Amen.
Next week, we're going to rest. following week we'll be at revival if it's the Lord's will in Ringo. Amen. So I mean, we're running Saturday night, the 18th. We'll be at my son of the house, Pastor Brooks. What's the name of that church? St. Abraham. Amen. Amen. I believe the third Sunday we're going to Pleasant Grove. Amen. So we're busy this month. Amen. And I often say, if God shows favor enough for folks to want you, you ought to want to go. These opportunities don't always come by. When opportunities are not, open the door. Amen. God bless you. And God keep you. So I got my blessing this week. I got some good word. And some good paths.
All right.
Big paths.
All right.
Amen. All right. Is there anything else? Wait a minute. You know what
I
you need to do some raising. Preacher said, I raised her.
Amen.
Amen. And in every chance I get, I want to help them.
Amen.
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 Amen. God bless you. And God keep. Do y'all see some Diane? She scared me when I first saw her. I've never seen her with a hair like that. Huh? Never know. Eastside, we thank God for you. Amen. Now, I don't know why they always holler. Behind every good man is a good woman. How come it can't be in front of every good woman is a good man?
Thank you.
see Brother Norman.
Amen.
Amen. Give him a hand.
Thank you.
this every Sunday. Yeah, everybody clapped up.
Yeah.
Thank you.
To be continued.
Thank you. All right, then. How you doing, brother?
You doing all right tonight?
Oh, yeah, all right.
All right, we're good, man.
No.
Hey, but come on a couple there. How you feeling tonight?
What's up, big guy?
You doing all right?
Yeah.
All right.
Hello, how you doing, sweetie?
That's okay, yeah, okay.
Look.